guys, what's up? Ron here from Helmholtz, and this is gonna be my first motovlog.
Hey guys, what's up? Ronio from Helmholtz, and today we are going towards Gadiyara, and this is going to be a group ride. So all the riders are going to meet up in front of the KBZ showroom near Chinar Park, Kolkata. Actually Salt Lake. So right now I'm crossing the second Hooghly Bridge, and as you can see, the second Hooghly Bridge really looks outstanding during the, you know, sunrise. And whenever I cross it during the morning times, it just feels awesome to cross the bridge. So right now I'm going to pick up one of my friends, Mr. Indranil Mukherjee. If you don't know who is he, so he's the other part of Helmholtz that you guys never see. He does the editing part and all those technical things. So right now I'll be picking him up from the PTS, the police training school. So right now crossing the Maa flyover, guys, and if you don't know, I want to tell you a fact about Maa flyover nowadays. That there are 3 or 4 speed sensors that has been placed by the police. If you don't follow the speed limit, you're gonna get a ticket definitely. So better follow the speed limit. So guys, right now we're in front of the KBZ showroom, and the riders are leaving the KBZ showroom because they will be meeting the other part of the batch, and they're waiting at the Belgaori Express Highway. So let's go and meet them up and complete the ride. So right now we are crossing the Belgaori Express Highway, and we will be meeting the other part of the riding team. You know what I believe is, riding as a group and riding solo is very different. You never get to experience the fellow brotherhood, the fellow, you know, help and all those skills that you can acquire from other riders while you ride solo. Riding as a group is very different, and it feels good while all the brothers are riding beside you and you know you're safe. I want to thank all the people in the group who helped us out. So right now we are going towards Gadiyara. We have crossed the rail line, the rail bridge that comes after taking left from Mulub area. So I want to say that you are going to face a lot of traffic if you go to Gadiyara. Don't always think that you are going to get free empty roads. There are empty roads, of course. You are traveling on the National Highway 16, and then after, when you go into the small, you know, this type of roads, you are going to experience a bit of traffic because this is a market area, of course. And the traffic is gonna be a little more worse if you're traveling at night. That problem that we faced while we are coming back. So there are a lot of autos and a lot of rickshaws over here. So be a bit more careful while you're riding, boss. They take left and right by their own wish. So while we're going towards Gadiyara, I don't know why one of our riding mates decided to open the helmet and feel the breeze. As riders, we have responsibilities, and I give a lot of gyan about helmets. So wear helmets, always wear proper helmets, and I really don't support this kind of things. But anyways, he may have thought of something. But as riders, I believe we have responsibilities to be taken and not ignored. So right now we are very close towards the Gadiyara tourist spot. We are roughly 8 to 10 kilometers away from there. The roads over here are very good, and riding over here was very exciting. But you have to remember one thing, that you are going to cruise at 60 to 80 on this kind of roads, because you know the tempo thing continues over here as well. Right now you can see a tempo stopping in front of me, and track almost crossing by. So there is no way I can stop if I am on very high speeds. So you have to be a little more careful, because there are a lot of tempos and people crossing, because this is a kind of a marketplace. So otherwise the roads are very good, they're clean, the people are helpful, so no worries about those. So we are very close to Gadiyara, 3.5 kilometers approx. So we'll be entering the Gadiyara tourist lodge now, and the Gadiyara tourist lodge is pretty good. I won't say it's a very good place, but it's quite good. The bookings are roughly 500 to 600 rupees per room. So right now we are entering the Gadiyara tourist spot lodge, and we had great fun over there. There were food arrangements and all those stuff done by the KBZ showroom guys. So thank you to them. Actually now we are heading towards the off-roading section, You have to take left from the Gadiyara tourist spot if you want to go to the place which I went. So we're going towards that. Let's see what can we find. Off-roading in this place was great fun, and if you guys go towards Gadiyara, I will request you guys, if you can, then please go to this off-roading patch portion of the road, and you will really get a very good experience if you like off-roading. And if you don't, I will still request you to get a taste of off-roading, guys, please. So right now we are going towards the end of the portion as far as we can go. So we believe that there is a small ground kind of a thing where we can go down. As we talk with the local people, they told us that. So right now we're heading towards that place. And you know what I believe is that whatever modifications I made, many people are criticizing me, but I believe whatever modifications I made to my bike are helping me a lot. So I really don't regret making those things. So all the bikes are parked and they're lined up. So we're gonna click some pictures. Thank you guys for watching this video. I hope you guys liked this video. And if you guys did not like this video, then please comment in the comment section below that what went wrong in this video and what can I do to improve this video and my vlogs. So I want to thank the KBZ people and the riding team people for giving us a very good experience for this Gadiyara ride. It was really helpful for vlogging as well and for riding as well with your team. And if you guys liked this video, then please subscribe as well. And don't forget to check us out on Instagram and Facebook. Thank you.